Welcome back, everybody. We are going to highlight Chef Brian Harmon's dish. He is the chef de cuisine at Madison City Grill in downtown Sarasota, and he's going to show us the dish that he's preparing for our banquet on the block, which is easy for you because you just step out the front door. Everyone else has to bring their stuff over.
Okay, let's get him started.
All right, we're going to start with a baby broccolini. Let's take some of this and cut the stalks off and clean the leaves off for me.
So broccolini, for those who don't know, is a combination of what?
It's broccoli and gailan. Gailan is Chinese broccoli.
Okay.
And it was invented in 93 in California, Salinas, California.
And you do see it on menus all over now.
Absolutely. More so now than in the past couple years. But, you know, it is fairly young for a vegetable.
Okay. Can I leave a little stalk?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Does it have a texture difference, a flavor difference? What's different?
Same as broccoli. It does have a asparagus undertone to it.
Okay.
And it's, actually its first name was Asparabroc until they decided to just call it
broccolini. It's a joke. Yes. It's like if broccoli and asparagus had a child.
It's their love child.
Yes. There it is.
Right.
Okay, so
perfect.
Broccolini's part of it.
Right.
What else have we got?
I'm gonna have Nikki start grating these potatoes for our potato cake.
And I don't have to peel it.
No, ma'am.
Ooh, I like that. Yeah. I might use more potatoes if I didn't have to peel them.
Right in the water with a little bit of salt, please. The salt's right in front of you.
Okay. Uh-huh. Now Joey has something in front of him I have never seen before. It is a very dark head of something.
That is black garlic.
Black
is what it's called.
Garlic.
Yes.
Is it different other than color than
it is
white?
Your normal typical garlic you find in the store. What is done is it's slow cooked. And what happens when you sear a steak, which we're going to do in a minute, the Maillard effect happens. And that's the browning of the protein and the sugars and everything in the meat. So this one was cooked about, I would say, 12 days. And it just slowly turns brown, about 120, 130 degrees.
That's
really,
crazy.
Really
it's
slow.
It's so aromatic.
You get kind of a balsamic and a tamarind flavor out of it.
Oh, fun. Okay, so we're using black garlic in the sauce? Is
yeah,
that how
we're
that
using
works?
That in the demi cream sauce today.
Okay. Wow, all right, well, so all right you've got them busy
so
over there.
If you'll just pop a couple of those out for me, then go ahead and chop your onion.
Oh, and they're soft because they've been cooked.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay, good.
Great.
All right, well, while he works on chopping his onion, I need you to talk to me a little bit about your meat preparation technique. I hear this word all the time, and I do not understand
it. Sous vide.
This is called a sous vide. I know they're very readily available now.
Absolutely.
For consumers, but what does it do and how does it work?
It's kind of the same process as the garlic we just spoke about, and it's a very slow, slow cooking. Like for this meat here, you kind of take your weight and then you take your temperature and time and you make up your recipe for cooking the meat.
Okay.
So this one in particular, you know, we had a pound that I cooked last night.
Okay.
And, you know, I started at 2 hours on 104 degrees. And then
so it is a very slow method.
Very slow.
And I submerge in water?
Yeah, completely submerged.
This Can I do that?
Absolutely. Go right
ahead. Okay.
This has a fan and a heater inside it, so it circulates the water to stay a constant 104 degrees.
So does this allow me to then actually cook the temperature and then later on I give it that sear?
Yeah, later on you create that crust, that extra flavor, that Maillard effect we were talking about with the garlic. That's what we're about to do
now. Well, so your steak's perfect every time.
It is, whether you want
Now I understand sous vide.
Yeah, it makes it really easy. And this you can just kind of set and forget about
it. So is this basically a beef tenderloin cut?
It's a teres major, and what it is, it comes from the shoulder blade of the cow, just under the shoulder.
Okay.
And you know, they compare it to a filet. I don't think it's quite as tender filet. There's a lot of fat around it. Teres major, that's correct.
Never heard about that. All right, let's sear this guy up.
All right, I've got some oil going already, so if you just want to pop it in there.
All right, I get the meat duty. All right.
We also put a fennel pollen on that to create a little crust.
This is something I've never heard of. Tell me what fennel pollen is.
It just comes once the pollen plant buds, just like any other plant. It creates this little
pollen.
Will
I be allergic to this? Because the whole pollen word is bad for me right now.
I hope not.
So talk about creative ingredients. Fennel pollen rubbed on our meat, which has been sous vide. Black garlic.
It's everything. It's taking everything to not pop one of these into my mouth.
Go ahead. Let's try some.
Do it.
Do it.
It's so good.
So it's not like eating a raw clove.
No. It's not as strong, but it's so flavorful.
And then the potato pancake with the broccolini in it.
No, ma'am.
A little of this.
Yep, we got the potato pancake shredded right there. She's putting just a little bit of truffle oil in it. A very long way, but it is delicious.
I don't think so.
Truffle oil. What's the green in my potato pancake?
The green is green onion.
Oh, just the green onion. Okay, so this is all coming together. An amazing fennel pollen-crusted Nyman Ranch steak served with broccolini and on a truffled potato pancake. And we put a little extra truffle in ours because we know we like it that way. Again, Enjoy Wine Fest is coming up the first weekend in April. It's a four-day event. Madison's will be part of it. So great to have Chef Brian here. Nikki, always a thrill. We are about to have new flavors. Take some time and enjoy this on Cozpio.